Hi guys, so today I'm doing a video on this look that I'm wearing. I'm not sure if you can actually see it because my lighting's been a little funny and I've been messing with it, trying to get it perfect, but for some reason I look a little bright, so you can't really even see any of the makeup on my face right now. But if you can, then great. I used a few of my favorite things palette from Too Faced, and I love this palette. The colors in it are amazing. And I just wanted to play around with it because I haven't really had the chance to play around with the palette. So I hope you guys enjoy this video, and if you have any questions, please feel free to leave them below and I will make sure to answer them.
So the first thing you're going to do is prime your eyes, and you're going to put that all over your eyelid and then bring it all the way up to your brow bone. And you want to make sure that you blend it out as much as possible and make sure you cover every area. This is going to help the eyeshadow look its actual color. And it'll also help it stay on for longer, and also add some to your lower lash line so that way you can have that primed as well. Then you're going to take the color Soft Brown by MAC, and you're just going to put that in your crease, and that is going to help with the transitioning of all the colors, especially because we're using lots of dark colors, so you want to make sure it all transitions nicely. Next, from a few of my favorite things palette from Too Faced, I'm taking the color Tinsel and just patting that onto my inner third. And you want to make sure you pat it on so that way there's not a lot of fallout. Now from that same palette, I'm just going to take the color Evergreen, and I'm just going to put that starting from the middle all the way out to my outer third. And you just want to keep it on the lid. You don't really want to go into the crease. And you just want to blend that into the Tinsel color as well. Now from the same palette, I'm taking the color Blue Satin Sashes, and I'm going to put that in my outer V, and then I'm going to blend it out into my crease. And you want to blend out as much as possible. Blending is the key to having a very good transition. Now taking a fluffy blending brush, you're going to add a little bit of Soft Brown, and you're just going to blend that over top of the Blue Satin Sashes that you just added, just to blend everything out and make the transition even and make sure there are not any harsh lines. Now taking the same palette, I'm using the color Moon Under Wings, and I'm just going to add that where you added the Blue Satin Sashes, and over top of that Soft Brown that you just added, and this is just going to help amplify the transition a little bit more. For a highlight, I'm using the color Cream Colored Ponies from the same exact palette, and to brighten up my eyes, I'm using the color Honey Honey, and I'm just going to put that into my inner corner, and this will help brighten and open up the eye. Now I'm taking Benefit's Erase Paste, and I'm just going to put that on my under eye area, and this is going to help not only brighten my under eye area, but also it's going to help me blend out and get rid of all of the fallout that I had while applying the eyeshadow. I like to blend this out with my beauty blender. I'm obsessed with it. You guys know this. It blends it out perfectly, and it takes out any excess stuff that I have on it. Next, I'm going to apply my concealer. I like applying my concealer before finishing my eye makeup just because I don't like to go over it and then get rid of any eyeshadow that I've already put on there. And once again, I'm going to blend that out with my beauty blender that I love so much. And I just feel like it makes everything look very precise. Okay, so now I'm taking a black eyeliner, and I'm just going to tightline and also add this to my waterline. And this is just going to deepen the look and make it a little more sultry, I suppose. Now you're going to take a small brush, and you're just going to add all the colors that you added on your lid to your bottom lash line. So I added Tinsel first, then Evergreen, and then Blue Satin Sashes. And I just made sure that the darker color stayed on the outer part of my lash line and the lighter colors on the inner corner of my lash line. Now to deepen the look just a little bit more, I went back in and added a little bit more of blue satin sashes and just blended that out a little bit more into the crease. Once again, now I'm taking a clean blending brush and I'm just going to blend that blue satin sash that I just added all over the crease just to deepen up the look a little bit. Now I'm adding some liquid liner and I'm going to wing it out. You guys know I love to wing it out. Then I'm going to curl my lashes and I'm going to add mascara. I will list all the mascaras below as well as any other things that I used. Now I'm going to add my foundation and I'm just going to dab it all onto my face. I have already primed my face. And then I'm going to take my beauty blender and you guys know I love my beauty blender. It's amazing. And I'm just going to blend out my whole foundation all over my face. Make sure it's blended as possible. So yeah. Next, to set my foundation, I'm going to use my Bare Minerals Matte Powder Foundation. And I'm just going to pat that all over my face. And I really like this stuff. It actually does set my foundation really well. So if you guys want to try it, I will list it down below. Then I'm going to contour a little bit, add some bronzer. I do this almost every day. I know it's a lot, but I love it. It gives some color to my face. Now I'm going to add some blush, and I like to kind of add it to the apples of my cheeks and then bring it all the way back to my hairline. And you just want to blend that all out. And for lips, I'm using M Cosmetics lipstick in Nude Lace, and over top of that, I'm going to add the NYX Lip Butter in Tiramisu. I love this combination. It is my favorite nude lipstick as of right now. You guys know I've had a hard time finding it, but honestly, it's one of my favorites. I love this combination, and the M Cosmetics lipsticks are amazing. I definitely want to try some more. So yeah, this is the look. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you have a very happy holiday, and I will see you soon with some New Year's tutorials. Bye!